It's Debbie.
Nobody makes gourmet burgers like we do. Uniquely created to be insanely delicious.
Red Robin.
Yum.
When I say Hillshire, you say farm. Hillshire.
Farm. Go meat.
But do you really know the truth about what we eat?
There's a few set of companies that are in control of the food that we're eating. Most of the food right now, what's happening in America is that it's more high on sugar and salt. Through their marketing, what they do is they capture young ones, adults, to do the easy way or the easy menu, right? Like the McDonald's. They also manufacture and actually design certain foods so that we can actually get used to them and continue to eat it, even though it's not good for us.
There are definitely a lot of problems with the current state of the food industry. A lot of those problems are actually governmental, or, you know, they're within the current legal framework in which all food is created in the United States. We have powerful industry groups that are able to lobby and persuade lawmakers to pass laws and rules that favor them and favor their ability to make profits and to make cheap food that is bad for people instead of slightly more expensive food that actually helps keep people healthy.
These regulatory agencies are being controlled by the very companies that they're supposed to be scrutinizing. In the 1970s, there were literally thousands of slaughterhouses in the United States, and today we have 13 slaughterhouses that process the majority of beef that is sold in the United States.
I've been eating this food all my life without having any idea where it comes from, any idea how powerful this industry is. And it was the idea of this world deliberately hidden from us.
With the way that we process and grow our chickens and cows, it's not healthy, and I think it's the cause of a lot of our health problems in the U.S.
If you could grow a chicken in 49 days, why would you want one you got to grow in 3 months? More money in your pocket.
Birds are now raised and slaughtered in half the time they were 50 years ago, but now they're twice as big. People like to eat white meat, so they redesigned the chicken to have large breasts.
Co-op members, we tend to organize a lot and lobby our legislators and try and make a difference there. But in addition, we very consciously route around the companies that are making the bad foods and go directly to the companies that are making the good foods. And so co-op members, we talk to each other and we share a lot of information. And in so doing, we make sure that all of us are eating better and better all the time.
Serving up good health, we educate, we feed, but we also educate, right? Because if we don't feed correctly, we just give them anything they can eat and just go. But we try to feed healthy and educate at the same time.
But we've got people in this neighborhood, mostly, who basically pay a little bit of money, like $15, at the beginning of the season, and they can garden for basically from like April or May until like October. Whatever food they grow is for themselves. Or if they want to give it to someone else, it's fine. But it's like they get their own garden space. And I don't know if any of you guys live near here, but a lot of these apartments, they don't have like a yard. Maybe a lot of them don't even have like balconies where they can grow stuff. So basically what our hope is that this just empowers people to grow their own food.
And the answer to childhood obesity and the answer to combating a lot of the chronic disease like diabetes and heart disease, the answer is in our backyards. We have to go back to the way it used to be back in the day, when mom and dad or grandma used to go back to the farm and pick crops and bring it back to our tables. Because it not only did it foster nutrition, it fostered unity, better communication, right? If we look at the problem with nutrition and obesity. And we're taking that very serious. I mean, we're not rich, but we're fighting.
We have all sorts of different volunteer work there. So no matter what your skill is, no matter what your interest is, there's almost always something that we can hook you up with that you'll enjoy and that you'll learn something new from.
Like if you go to the bathroom, it's, you know, yellow, then that means we're dehydrated, and it's hard to, like, you know, stop. If I'm drinking soda and juice all the time, it's hard to just stop like that and then drink water.
And that's how it starts.
Like all the time. It's hard. And then when you see it in front of you, it's all cold and nice thing. How you open it, you hear that sound and make you want to drink.
It's like kinda how we were taught. Like if you be good, I'll give you a snack.
Right, you be
like,
good, I'll give you a treat.
Like come on, come on, yeah. Come on.
Can I take your order, please?
I mean, in a democratic, capitalistic society, the best way to change things is to just use your money.
You gotta know what you're buying, like know what's in it. Not get fooled by the labels.
Basically, you shouldn't buy something for its price or its label. Like you should buy it for like its quality and how it would affect your health.
Food isn't just slapping on, you know, a barcode or a label onto an item, like. It's about, you know, farmers producing healthy food for people to consume.
They're lying to us. They put a fake picture on their thing. They should have, like, a real picture. Like, this is where your food is coming from.
They're not going to make money. They have to put up there what the consumer wants to see. They want to see something happy. They don't want to know what's actually going on. They really did, baby. Nobody
would be eating that type of food. I know, but like, we're the ones who are buying it. We need to know what's in it.